Even if you're a VTuber, you're human too.
They are not human.
Bakit?
They're anime. No.
Okay, time to sleep, delusional. Okay. Here's your bib.
Take your meds.
Take your meds.
Take your meds.
Take your meds.
This is the 97th episode of the podcast. Jay Agonoy po. Keepsakes, Happy New Year, and welcome back to me. Ang tagal kong hindi nag-podcast. It's been months since I did my last podcast, previously with Lauren Orsini, otaku journalist. Again, one of my inspirations. It just so happens that by December, it's already event season and everybody's having their own festivities. And therefore, I'm too much busy with online events work. So now that it's January already, the fireworks are gone, the New Year's in, it's 2022, and I have with me special guests on this episode. On this episode, we have my good friend, Kurumeme.
Domo.
Hi. I thought you were saying domo ariga thanks, but never mind that. We have Arb on the next line.
Arb. Hello there.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
Yeah. And then we have a VTuber. So by the name of Vivirasuto.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so sa lahat ng mga familiar sa buong community, ang pinakakilala ko dito is si Kurumeme at si Vivirasuto. So, let's start with Arb. Arb, what do you do?
Right now, I do a lot of things because I am practically a support for like a lot of people. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to be active right now on a lot of projects that a lot of indie VTubers or actually any indie otaite right now are trying to do. So for starters, like recently I'm planning this event wherein VTubers get to showcase their singing prowess, because mostly I dabble on anything that is music related and stuff like that.
So you know, no, so yeah, we'll talk about more of that later on. So yeah, okay. We'll start with, of course, si Kurumeme muna. Anong ginawa mo nung New Year?
Nanood ng VTuber.
Nice. Ako din. Nanood din ako ng VTubers.
Solid. Bagay talaga sa VTuber podcast. Nanonood ng VTuber.
Yes.
Nice.
So, sino yung huli mong pinanood bago mag-strike yung 12 midnight?
Sino nga ba? Nanood ako ng art. Hindi ko suha.
Kuzuha. Kuzuha nag-New Year stream? Ayos?
Nanood ako ng archive niya.
Archive? Okay. Archive naman pala ni Kuzuha. Kasi I was, New Year, I was, ano, before, so, siguro, ano, ang new, pang bungad ko sa New Year is yung Hope in the Dark ng Luxiem. Galing ni, ano eh, galing ni Chiban yan eh. Yung track ni Chiban yan talaga eh. Doon ako hanga-hanga eh. Especially yung, ano, yung interlude.
Chiban yan.
Oo. Diba niyan, oo. Oh, okay. Okay.
Season 2, Gomikasu. Onegaishimasu.
Yes.
Onegaishimasu.
Nagsimula yan sa Gomikasu and then eto na, Hope in the Dark. Oh. Oh, sana tayo ngayon. Congrats, Chiba niyan. Okay. So, yun. Okay, next up, Arb. What did you do nung New Year's Eve?
On New Year's Eve, I was actually doing a lot of work. So, basically, I was catching up on a lot of backlog works before celebrating the New Year's. But after that, I went ahead and watched NJU alongside Kurt, wherein we were practically talking about it, fanboying on a lot of stuff that is happening. It was very exciting.
And after that,
I also watched NJU actually.
NJU is really good. I like that they do it every year. And the next thing I watched was Hololive. New Year's End stream, which they always do. It's kind of amazing to see them all in one stream together, really.
Like, for example, the New Year's costume reveals, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Their costumes are really cute.
Yes, especially the most narcissistic New Year's costume I've ever seen.
Laplace!
Laplace. So, you see Laplace in the face and then you see another Laplace in the New Year's dress. So, how about that?
Solid.
Solid, solid.
Big brain moment.
Yeah, right? Right? Yung hindi mo mapapansin si Laplace. Oh, I was looking at your chest. Oh, there's Laplace face in it.
Truly wagahay moment.
Wagahay moment. Imagine Hololive.
Imagine.
And then siguro ano pa ba nangyari? So far we have already have breaking hindi na nga breaking news to eh. So there's New Year streams tapos sa Indonesia I'm monitoring this one small agency and then yung Holox nga nagkaroon ng new costume and then the Niji Sanji Express. Have you been to the Niji Sanji Express?
Niji Sanji Express is pretty exciting. I like the tracks that they made, yung arrangement nila.
I love the environment. I've been to VR chat and yun, I hope they let it stay for more than a month talaga kasi truth be told in ang ganda ng concept ni Selene. Si Selene nagbuhat ng bangko for that. All right, so Niji Sanji Express,
seen
yes.
It yet.
Pero you do have VR chat to see it.
Oh yeah, I do have VR chat but I haven't heard of what Niji Express is actually.
Yeah,
it's basically something that Pomo and Selene came up with and they did a tour about it just yesterday. Was it yesterday?
Oh, yeah. It's a VR chat world.
VR chat world.
Nice.
Diba?
And it's open to public after they did the tour and now it's open to public.
Oh, that's cute.
Para isang buong buwan, puro fireworks, puro Happy New Year ni Jisanji.
Aww.
Oo, di ba? Ang ganda nun. You should check that out. Yun nga.
I will.
And then, di ba, not to mention, Hololive English already released the cover of Ocha Mekino. Yung pinaka...
Yeah.
The yearly Ocha Mekino.
Yeah.
They're printing it. Yun lang.
Everyone has their own cover now. Indonesia, Japan... The new gen now English.
Now English.
So susunod-sunod na. Next year naman 2023 kung may madagdag sa Hololive. I guess may madadagdag kasi they just opened the
They just opened a new edition.
So
but they're actually using the old page for the auditions. But yeah.
The thing about Hololive is that alam na nila kung anong ginagawa nila sa buhay nila halos when it comes to auditions and they just opened it for everyone to register kung sino man gusto mag-sign up. Maybe ano so ngayon siguro dagsa yung applications nila and then from time to time parang job application lang.
Yeah. Oo. Like a normal job position.
Yeah, 'di ba? Oo. So 'yun, pag nag-announce sila ng bagong generation, edi ready na yung mga records. Talk to you later na lang. Oo. Tapos meron ng bago ngayon na VTuber. Her name is Inuchi Tenten. Pero she's not a new VTuber. She is an independent VTuber before na accepted by Yashin Live. Accepted kasi...
Gen Zero?
Gen Zero, oo. Yeah, she's accepted by Yashin Live. Kasi wala nang ano, kumbaga nag-upgrade siya. Okay. Tapos, done na. And she's streaming on GMT... plus 4 ba or
really?
Somewhere along ano kasi hindi 4 a.m. siya nag-stream kanina on her debut and so far I'm looking for her to see clips kasi yun niya, the challenge for indie VTubers is how to get your name there, di ba?
Yeah, that's true.
Ang magiging manager mo ang CEO mo si Dasu, so paano yan, di ba? Plus points. So yun yung recap natin ng mga balita. No? We actually talk about news about VTubers this time. Ano? Something na hindi ko ginagawa every animazing show because most of the time I talk about interviews there. But yeah, it will continue naman, animazing show. We're just ironing things out. Baka kung anong mangyari sa amin. Alright, so moving back, we have here someone who has been supporting VTubers from the sidelines on a different role, and we have a VTuber who's independent and who is paano ba to? Yeah, independent and kicking in the year. So siguro naman we can have a good discussion here. So
yes.
All right. So first, let me put the spotlight to Arb. So you mentioned that you're doing support tasks for VTubers, and from your experience alone, without siguro, just give us a basic experience. Are there reasons why VTubers need someone to manage them?
Yes. So regarding that, it's not that VTubers need someone to manage them. It's more like, do you really need someone to manage you?
Mm.
So, something like that. Because lahat naman ng VTubers or lahat naman ng tao may different capacity regarding on how they handle their content, right? And in some cases, I think it's important that there is someone to support you to handle all of the logistics related stuff. Like for example, arranging the production for the song that you're gonna be releasing. Matrabaho kasi yung may pag-usap ka pa with the mixer, with the artist, and to coordinate with them. It really helps that there is always someone that's gonna be doing the arrangements that understands what needs to be done sa ilalabas mong next content or next cover. So, sabi na natin that person understands your strength. Then that's the that's where the part comes in na oo, kailangan mo yung ano, support na yon. But sabi na natin kung yung person naman na ano na nagmamanage sa iyo is that they don't really understand what you are trying to achieve with this cover or what are you trying to achieve with this content that you're trying to release. I think you're better off alone.
Mm.
Something like that.
Mm-mm. Kasi 'di ba in terms of ano, you kumbaga for example, sige, I'll put the spotlight on Vivi this time. Naghirap ka na sa pagbili ng mic, ng equipment and all. And then kailangan mo pa ng audio editor. So, 'di ba?
Yeah.
I think it's tedious on your part, tama?
Yeah, I am doing everything on my own as of the moment. So, gets ko yung sinasabi ni Arb na yung ano, parang for me, madali siya na ikaw mag-contact ng artist, ganyan. Ikaw mag-contact ng gagawin ng MV, ng mag-mimix. But unfortunately, a lot of people that get into VTubing don't really know about those stuff. So, when they want, for example, to do a cover, they don't know where to start, ganyan. Mm. So, it help people like Arb help them out a lot. And then, I see a lot of similar people like Arb in the community, and they're very helpful for us VTubers. But for me, as I'm doing all everything on my own.
Mm-mm. Okay. Let's compare the experiences. For a moment, ano? Kasi okay, we now talk about song covers. For example, ano pa bang sikat na mga kanta na kinakanta ngayon? We started with Shin Takarajima, and then King, and then King. Vampire.
Empire.
Ano na bang usong kanta na kino-cover ng mga VTubers?
Kami Poy.
Kami Poy, oo.
Gold. Ay, Honey. Honey.
Honey?
Medyo naging patok din yung ano, yung Goodbye Sengen.
Ay, Goodbye Sengen, yes.
Naging patok din yun.
Oo. I do remember a cover. Pero parang parody cover siya ng isang Indonesian VTuber na pang nagangalan sa Jared Fajianto. I don't know guys if you know them, pero nakatutok ako doon, is about the internet connection. So we're sharing the same parallel. It's not even parallel at this point. The Philippines and Indonesia have that kind of internet infrastructure. Oh.
It will be like that. Well, currently rise up.
Internet brothers
talaga. So in ano, okay, so let's start with the whole scenario. Let's say kunwari VTuber ako yung isang giga pudding na VTuber. What? I have this asset kasi na may ano eh, I bought this asset na ano, pudding leche plan.
Yeah.
So I think that's valid ano, it's around 250 pesos sa boot. Okay, yun nga, gagawa ko ng kanta. So, ang kanta is Fly Me to the Moon, yung ending ng Evangelion. si jazz cover, and then I'll have to ano ba yon? Do you compose your tracks or nanghihiram na lang kayo ng assets sa iba?
That depends on how much you are willing to expend kasi. So, sabi na natin gusto mo ng ano, talagang high quality cover, then you will get someone to arrange something for you. Pero kung ano naman, kung you're looking to manage your cost naman, pwede ka naman lang may pag-coordinate lang sa may ano, sa mga existing arrangement na ginawa ng ano, mga composers, and then dun kayo papasok sa usapan kung paano yung ano, kung paano mo makokompensate yung artist kapag gagamitin mo yung track nila. Pero pero ang usual scenario kasi, there are a lot of artists or composers that are willing to lend their tracks to people as long as you ask.
Yeah, that's true.
So for example, yung ano ba nagawa mo ngayon na cover, Vivi? Meron ba?
Meron ako, pero may na-record na ako, may napamix na ako. Pero so far, I've been having a hard time producing the MV kasi I'm managing my costs, pero ano, inuna ko kasi yung PC. Yung PC pa yung stream muna. So, I haven't really commissioned anyone to make an MV. Pero I've been eyeing some people na usually it ranges from 40 USD for a good one until 150 USD. So, ayun.
Oh, good deal, good deal.
So, 150 USD is like 5,000 pesos. Plus
7,500 mga ganun.
And then yung backing track mo pa, ano, 'di ba? Yung ano, kasi 'di ba? Paano ba yung backing track?
Usually kung may kuwari yung original artist, kung nag-release sila ng backing track, I just use that kasi in the end makaka-copyright strike. Makaka-copyright naman. So no, I have avoiding it if, especially kung hindi ka naman ganun kayaman. Pero I usually just use the backing track provided by provided by the original artist.
So yun ano, so for example, someone covers King, may backing track na yun ano from ano ba yun? Who composed
Anaria.
That?
Yeah.
Anaria, yes.
It's available on Pia Pro. It's usually the site where Japanese producers or artists give their content for free or sometimes with a price.
Pia Pro, ano? Which reminds me, Pia Pro is Hatsune Miku, started with the Vocaloid community, right?
Yes.
And then they're still continuing naman, ano? Pero King was originally sung by a Vocaloid, tama?
Yeah.
Ayun. Yeah. So, doon na nga. So, tapos biglang everybody singing King nowadays to the point na pag i-rank mo yung covers ng mga songs from any other VTuber, mapa Hololive or Niji Sanji or Kuzua man yan, hindi na siya nirarank. May isang ranking doon, VTuber song cover rankings, no King allowed.
Nakahilera na sila doon.
Nakahilera na sa Hall of Fame. So, hindi na kailangan i-rank. Kahit sino pang kumanta niyan. Tapos yung Vampire, di ba? Susunod na yung Vampire eh. Yeah. It, until now, it gets stuck in my head. Ano, ganun kalupit yung kanta. Di ba? Imasukya.
Maka-copyright tayo nito.
Imagine not using the backing track. Pero yun nga, ano, moving forward, yun nga. So that's one example, song covers. And then we have the, yun nga. Hindi pa natin na-explore masyado yung music videos eh. Because there's a variety of applications. How would you do a music video?
Kung, yeah.
Pero ano, it all boils down to skill, to the editing skill. So, magkano ba ang usual na ano rate for this kind of market?
Standard is 60 USD and above.
60 above, ano?
Pag binakit ka na 40, parang, mura! Ngayon na, tapos ako naman na agad. But usually 60 and above. I see 60 USD from Indonesian animators who use Adobe After Effects. And then yung mga 100 to 150, either super ganda na animation from Indonesian na gumagamit ng After Effects, or parang standard animation pa lang for Western animators, ganun.
Ang lupit, ha? There's really people who are offering that kind. Pero do you, where do you explore that? Do you explore that on Twitter or Fiverr?
Twitter.
Twitter usually.
You don't do Fiverr, no?
You don't do Fiverr, no?
Yeah. It's risky.
Risky. Okay, so yun nga, ano? So tapos na yung video, tapos ilalunch na, tapos may pa, kunwari may pa-teaser pa, ano? Diba? Oo. And come to think of it, some VTubers do tease parts of it on either Twitter or teaser sa YouTube. Okay, so let me ask this to Vivi, to your experience. Is it required na marunong ka mag-edit ng videos or mag-clip man lang halos?
Clipping very important. Because people don't usually watch full vods, and that's very understandable because people use a lot of their time on more important things. But clipping is very important. At least kahit mag-trim ka lang mag-video, sana marunong ka lang mag-trim. And then, you don't really have to know complex editing, inserting memes, or even editing for music videos, because some people online do it for a really cheap price, and you can ask them to do it for you. Si Kurumeme Clipper, I think he has commissions open for clipping, and I think a lot of similar people also have commissions open for those kinds of things, in case you don't know how to.
Sige, Kurumeme, magkano commission mo pagkano? If someone approaches you, tapos pa-clip, pa-edit ng clip, ganun.
It really depends kung gano'ng kadami yung members sa stream. Pero sabihin natin, one person, then 5 minutes, $3. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Barat-barat?
Ba't barat?
Mababarat pa. Hindi, I mean, ano, and that's already, ano, kumbaga, cheap na rin yun kung totoo, ano, $3.
Yeah, it's very cheap, very cheap.
Very cheap, po. Okay.
Mga makikita mo po, 10.
Iba rin yung, ano, iba rin yung creative industry na this time sa VTubers. Kasi wala kang makikita, wala kang maririnig na, ano, na parang sasabog na lang ng issue na kagaya nung Zen Pro Gaming. Talala nyo? Zen Pro Gaming,
no.
Pumotok yung issue niya na nangunguripot siya. He's a streamer ng Mobile Legends, and then nangunguripot siya ng editors. Uh-huh. So, of course, umalma ang buong community. So, the poor guy got... And he reacted badly to that. So, poor guy, he lost sponsorships.
Is it common?
I remember that.
Diba?
It's very common. Underpaid editors.
Mm-mm.
In VTubing?
No. Outside VTubing, meron ano. Pero inside VTubing, wala akong maririnig na ganyan.
Yeah, I haven't seen a lot either.
Actually, willing pa nga sila usually mag-lower pa ng price eh. Yun yung pinaka-amazing na nakikita ko dito. Like, usually they'd ask you on a price that you can work with, and medyo konting negotiation lang, and they will usually agree to that price that you can spend.
And then yung binayad mo sa kanila, ibabayad nila pabalik sa'yo through super chats.
Totoo, may mga ganun.
Circular, ang tawag doon is circular economy. Yes.
Mention mo na lang ako.
It's basically how YouTubing works here. You commission an artist, the artist pays a super chat, and then the super chat money, they use it to produce an MV, and then the MV producer super chats another VTuber.
It never ends. As long as there are people who can super chat, siguro the circular economy goes on. Yun yung ano, I think that's the reason why people are allured to entering ano, aside from super chats, and then the second is yung itatago nila kung sino man sila, diba, for their privacy na rin. Kasi mahirap din yung if, unlike me, na ganito na ako kakupal, so people see me as kupal forever. And then I wear something like a leche flan na VTuber model, tapos kupal ako, matutuwa pa sila. Instead na makikita mo yung mukha nitong gagong to. Diba? Instead na makikita mo ba yung ano, maging leche flan ka na lang, leche ka.
Saka I think it's psychological as well na the fact that you are hiding behind an avatar. I think it really boosts the person's confidence as well. Like they are able to project themselves more on that avatar usually.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-mm. Kasi hindi lang naman yan depicted well in real life. Eh. It's also depicted in manga. There's this manga called I Fell in Love So I Tried Live Streaming and they have VTubers. Tapos yung they are a different character. Tapos we do like that, ano. So that's something I'm looking forward to, a VTuber anime in 2023. How about that? As in actual na, ano, kasi di ba previously mga series wherein VTubers are cast. For example, kay Sora. Sora saka ano, Rory Asano before she became a legit voice actress talaga for real.
Then mga ano, tawag dito, artist na nagiging opening ano, artist ng mga video.
Opening artist, oo. Yung mga ano, for example, si Uy Mama.
Si Gucci Kaede.
Mm.
Yung extend something anime. 100%.
Mm. So naging opening act na si Deron, oo. Deron talaga, yeah. Lupit din Deron eh.
Si ano ba? Si Yuni.
Yuni, oo, Yuni.
Yuni. Yeah.
Especially Yuni.
Uzaki.
Yeah, nga pa, Uzaki-chan. No? Thank you for that. Tapos yun nga, si Rory Asano of the Asano Sisters Project na siya ngayon magbo-voices for Dropkick on My Devil, the upcoming season.
The Jashin.
Not to mention, Jashin-chan Dropkick. Let's not forget, Maho Shoujo Psych. Kizuna Ai. Sino pa ba doon? Sino pa ba nag-voice? I think hindi lang si Kizuna yung ano, yung nag-voices doon eh. Yeah. I think I'll get back to that ano. So, yun nga ano, we are already at the time where the more VTubers we got from there's a lot of hidden gems in the rough. Tapos nagiging talent sila for a lot of other forms of media.
Oh.
And at the same time, for example, si Amalie. Si ano, Multiverse Monarch. Oh, so,
Amalie is now a VTuber.
Oh, Multiverse Monarch. Oh, di ba?
Beat Mario.
Beat Mario. Oh, ano, Beat Mario, which is... Saan nga siya nag-guest last time? Ni Jisanji, no?
No, sa Hololive. We're alongside with Marin. Kasama nila si Zun.
Oh, pero one time, I think, Beat Mario surprised Pomo? Is that Pomo?
I'm not sure, but Beat Mario does interact with a lot of Niji Sanji VTubers as well.
Mm-mm. And then, of course, hindi natin makakalimutan yung katulad ni Pochi. Pochi Mama. Uy Mama.
Si Mama.
And Ito Life.
Ayun. Meron pang isang VTuber na actual light novel author eh.
Oh?
Yeah. We covered that sa Anime Corner before. Now I have to turn to that, ano. So meanwhile, commercial break lang muna, Anime Corner. At Anime Corner, we're now announcing that aside from the news team which covers anime, we'll be developing a news team that also covers VTubers. So stay tuned to Anime Corner and on Facebook as we are firing these things out. Ayun. So, yun nga, no? Meron din akong kilala na cosplayer who is eventually a VTuber na.
Ooh!
Hindi ko sasabihin. it's not on my proper judgment. Ayun. So, yun nga, no? Mamalay ko ba kung yung cosplayer na pinipicturan ko sa cons is VTuber na rin? So, I'm interested to meeting you guys. If you're willing, kasi above all ang mindset ko naman sa buhay, ang focus ko sa buhay, focus
lang sa goal.
Focus lang sa goal. Ang goal is that even if you're a VTuber, you're human too. Everybody's human. Nope.
They're not. They are not human.
Ayan na. Hot take.
Hot take. Oh. Oh, bakit? State your case.
I don't live with in real life. They're anime. Duh.
Okay, time to sleep, delusional. Okay. Here's your bed.
Kurumi, take your meds.
Take your meds. Take your meds.
Take your meds.
Take your meds.
Take your meds.
So, yun nga.
Sinisira niya yung storyline nila eh.
The narrative, the narrative. Oo nga naman, actually. Because they also
the
have narrative,
their own narrative only stays alive for 1 month. That's it.
I know, right?
The narrative yun. Ito yung malupit eh. Ito yung malupit sa lore. So, okay, kakademyo pa lang. Here's the lore. Okay, sometimes napaka-ingrande ng lore mo tapos makikita kita you're submissive and breedable. Just like ano, yung nga, 'di ba? Oo, 'di ba ganoon minsan madalas ganoon nangyayari yung pagka-season mo, 1 month, give it a month, wala na. Finish na. Thank you, God bless.
Di ba? Hindi ko din gets yung nagsusulat ng pagkahaba-habang mga lore like 3 pages. What?
Yung akin, kumain lang ako ng panis na sinigang naging bata ako.
Yun pala yung ingredient ton, same ingredient with that of Conan's.
Oo. Yung ano nangyari.
Oo, naging...
Matagal-tagal bago ko mahanap yung antidote. Sobra mga 900 chapters.
900 chapters?
ganun lang.
Tapos yung iba naman, wala talagang kalor-lore. That's it. As in, hindi nila...
Sabak agad.
Sabak agad. That's it. Oo, wala na kalor-lore eh. Yun nga, for example, yung kaka-mention ko lang na kaka-debut na VTuber, ang lore is, she found a laptop and she found magical wifi, so that's why she can stream.
What the? No?
Okay.
Giga brain.
Giga brain moment. That's a very simple lore, to be honest. Kahit ako, okay, as someone who looks into stories, as someone who loves to hear stories from other people, okay na yun sa akin. Instead na, you were from the past, and then, you got immersed so much in your environment currently na hindi ka na say so.
Meron din yung mga, yung mga devil na pinalayas sa hell, and then, naging interested sila sa live streaming.
Oo. Oo, tapos yung iba tapos yung sinasabi niya TMT Magi Tenshi, ganun. Oo. Kumbaga para nawawala na yung pagka-demonyo nila, 'di ba?
Na-cleanse na ah.
Na-cleanse na ng na-tame na dito sa mundong ibabaw. So 'yun, those are the things that us viewers, us connoisseurs, parang ang lalim naman sinasabi ko. Mahilig lang kami sa VTubers, that's it.
So tambay lang po kami sa bahay.
Tambay lang po. Yeah. Palamunin lang po kami.
Kuya Jay, ba't ka na may personal?
Who hurt you? Who hurt you?
You hurt me.
Ayun lang.
Yun lang. Masakit, no? Masakit talaga ang katotohanan. But it should set you free. Did it. Mm-mm. Tapos of course there's a lot of stories about yun nga agency. So moving back to the thing we talk about yung MV, how the indies do it and then there's a requirement na may manager, and then we talk about agencies, yung mga smaller agencies natin. Alam nyo, okay, dropping names, Cometa pa lang so far yung kita ko na registered dito sa Pilipinas, and then yung about trademarks, Hololive and Niji Sanji are already registered here in the Philippines. It's just the difference is Niji Sanji is a global trademark.
Yeah, they have been trademarked since. But I don't know about Hololive. I think they just got trademarked recently because I noticed that back then I keep bringing it up with Kurumi before that. I noticed that Hololive is not trademarked. So mm-hmm. I was joking around saying that maybe we could claim Hololive's name and then sue them.
That's what that. Here's the thing. Ito yung binibring up ko sa isang blog post ko, ano. Hololive is a trademark already for a holographic piece of equipment, a tool that shows you parang the holograph measurements and all for construction. Yun talaga. Kaya hindi yung mai-trademark ang Hololive. You could trademark Hololive English, you could trademark the names of Holomit. Pero costly eh.
Yeah, hindi nila ma-trademark because Hololive or Cover Corporation started as a VR company, company.
Ito talaga ni Jisanji from the get-go. We decided, global trademark. Okay tayo. Ni Jisanji, that's it.
Yeah.
At saka hindi ko pa na-explore yung buong history ng ni Jisanji kung paano sila nabuo and how they went up 207 VTubers for Japan and 15 VTubers for EN. Dami eh.
Kabitan ako pangalan na lahat.
Hindi ako ganun ka. Hindi ako hari ng Hololive Groups.
Ni Jisanji fan ka, pangalanan mo lahat ng VTubers nila.
Minsan nagugulat ka na yung pinapanood mong hindi pala.
Diba? tapos yung pinapanood mo na ni, akala mo ni Jisanji, yun pala, hindi siya hindi part pala, ng ni Jisanji. Hindi pala siya. Oo. Diba?
I mean, ni Jisanji came from very humble beginnings. Like, eto nga si Tsukinomito started streaming on top of washing machine, right? That's the legendary stream, Tsukinomito.
Really?
Yeah. Yung laptop niya pa noon karag-karag.
Nice.
So, you can see that her older popular videos, her model is very very laggy. It's because she's streaming on an old laptop on top of washing machine. And look where she is right now.
Potato PC.
Very humble beginnings ni Jisanji.
So, nag-start yun kay Mito, diba? And then, aside from Tazumi, si Tazumi kasi ang mukha ng ano eh, siya yung hinahambing kay Yago this time.
Yago, yes.
Oo, kay Yago. Oo. Pero yun nga, ano, I never really explored yung history ng ni Jisanji. How they went up 207 VTubers plus 15 plus others.
I think it's because Ninji Sanji has a more general market. Like, kahit hindi may sa anime, tina-target nila. So, they're getting as much people from all walks of life as much as possible.
Or maybe...
World domination.
Dominate the virtual world.
Or maybe, hindi idol?
Yes! Exactly. Yeah. Yan yung pinaka main takeaway ng Nijisanji. They are not idols but they are more like entertainers in general.
Like Nijisanji. Oo, ito yung ano, this is the hottest take na ilalapag ko dito on this floor. Na talagang makikita niyo yung bias ko for Nijisanji ano. Hololive, comedian. And then Nijisanji, comedian. Okay, learn the difference. It will save your life. Diba? Yun yung ano eh. Nununa? Comedian. Ay, nako. So yun nga ano. So, of course, we ended up talking about comparing Hololive ni Jisanji in which hindi na dapat nababanggit yung comparison na yan because it's already there. It's already laid out. We're just being an echo chamber here. So, moving back to mga other agencies nga, of course, there are incidents. We've had our guest before, the name's Termi Koizumi. And she just finished, kumbaga, when we learned about her, she just went off from, she bought herself out of her agency.
Yeah, Amberlow.
Yeah, Amber Glow. Oo. Pero yun nga eh, which brings up yung mga issues about management, not really a management yung group, ganon. Just recently, Otahu Project this has decided that they're going on a hiatus and its talents will be its talents will be on
acting independently.
Kumbaga they're on their own this time until na ano they sort out themselves. So yun nga no, another is yeah, I don't think nabanggit ko na to, but in Indonesia there's this small agency, small kasi apat ang VTubers nila, apat ang talents nila. It's called Nakama Virtual, and they just agreed na yung tatlong talents nila will be independent. So this year independent na yung tatlong talents nila. The fourth talent nag-resign yung voice behind it. On I think it's on good terms naman. Wala naman masyadong pumutok na balita. Binanggit na lang ng management out of siguro transparency or not. I wrote that story for Anime Corner dahil they sent us a reference, ano, the agency sent us a reference. So, yun, that's how things work naman, and yeah, looking forward to for more of their activities this year. So, going back, yun nga, ano, anyone remembers like Deep Sea Productions, which now
yes,
which is now presently.
Go ahead. Sorry.
Sige. So yun nga no, natuto ang Deep Sea, which is now Crescent Link, sa kanilang mga pinagagawa sa buhay nila. And so natuto sila, and I'm happy naman and proud na they learned from their lessons, and now they're a successful group. With Haniel and sino ba yung ano? Sino ba yung isa?
Oh, sina
Nevi.
Nevi.
Nevi, Dula.
Kasi Diana Yao. Diana?
Ayun. Uh-oh. Ayun, Diana!
Diana Yao. Oh. Yao!
Well, it's good to hear that they're successful, because back then, when the whole issues sprouted, I actually didn't hide my disdain or my opinion
I did it. You know what? Kasama natin yung isa sa mga staff nila on our previous podcast last year.
Oh.
Di ba? Was it last year?
Oh, I heard from Kurumi.
Mm-mm. So yun nga, ano. Okay. And then this, ano. Of course, ito talaga, yun, eh. Hindi siya masarap na pakinggan. Pero parang bakit ang sarap balik-balikan nito? This is a case study kasi. This one agency called Coral Corporation. Or is it an agency? Coral Corporation. It's Pearl Orient Productions.
Yeah, Pearl Orient.
Uh-huh. Pearl Orient na hindi na bumalik yung CEO sa mga talents and everything nila, and decided na...
I've not heard of that.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So, yun. In that case, di ko nababanggitin yung mga talents. They're all independent on their own. Pero at that time kasi parang yun na yung case study. They got exposed by one of their talents na ganito nga yung nangyayari. So sikat na sila worldwide, and I was able to talk to the one who wrote the report on that expose, yeah. You know.
Uh-huh.
So ang liit ng mundo. it's really a small world. And I meron pa sa Indonesia, chismis. You know, po chismis ang to, no? And pero ito yung mga chismis na talagang nandyan na as balita talaga. They're part of history. Yeah. Imagine one VTuber playing dead.
Playing dead?
The one that commissioned Zenter Chicken. Yeah.
Oh, that's another story. That's another story.
Oh, this is different.
Yeah, this is different. Yeah. Diba?
Different.
Oh. That was in Indonesia. Pinatalsik siya ng mismong grupo niya. It's not an agency. Pero this one, yun nga, thank you for mentioning that. Yung ano nga si Ao9. Actually before Ao9, yung model niya is
what about her name?
Yeah, 'di ba? Ano sa one time we talked about this sa HoYoFest ni Kurumeme, so yeah. ako din frustrated din ako kasi Pilipinas na naman. Pilipinas na naman.
Tayo na naman.
Playing dead so that you won't pay for the avatar.
Oh,
what a bitch. Fuck you.
Hindi na naitawa ni Kurumeme frustration din.
Yeah. Galit na galit yan eh. Nung nangyari yun, like, uy, huntingin nga natin to.
Oh, ako din, galit na galit din ako. Kasi Pilipinas na naman.
Kaya, okay.
Tapos yung artist pa, behind the live 2D, parang first client niya yun. Tapos ang cheap pa ng prices niya. Nagalap siya ng mamahalin na anak. Tapos nagagaganan siya. Parang,
wala throw hands. Nakaka-promo siya.
Mm-mm. Totoo. So yun, at best, someone bought the model and we now know her by the name Aonine. Mm. Or Aoi9. In which, hinihintay natin siya mag-debut.
Mm.
Sa lahat ng mga VTuber na nakausap ko, siya yung unang nag-approach sa akin.
Siya, in-approach niya din ako.
Ako din! Diba?
Ay!
Sana all ina-approach.
Nanonood daw siya ng clip ko.
Ayun, no? Ay!
Basically, my girlfriend.
So, yun, ano? We're just waiting for updates from Aoi9. Kung anong, what will happen, ano? So, yeah. Looking forward. Siguro it will take time. It will take months. Kasi, kailan lang ito nangyari? November. Oh, it's January pa lang. So, wait pa tayo. 3 to 6 months yan. It's 3 to 6 months. Ganon. 3 to 6 months. So, yeah. Napasarapin usapan natin. Where was I? So, we went so off tangent, but we still talk about VTubers, so everything's in full circle. So yeah, another problem is yung internet connection. Recently, Cometa Virtual Live suspended activities on YouTube dahil palyado ang internet nila and Cometa is doing their best to get these talents. Tatlo sila. Some good ass internet connection.
Walang ganun sa Pinas. Word lang.
Galit ako sa internet ng Pinas. Imagine that.
I mean, we can't really blame them kasi alam natin experience ng internet dito.
Oo. Pero you know, the infrastructure, ito na nga, ang dami na nga. Naging internet, web 3.0 na nga tayo dito eh. Tapos na nga web 2.0 eh. Andyan na nga yung Axie eh. Tapos yung Zoom. And then, improving pa rin yung internet infrastructure natin. How long could we go like this? Ay, sabihin mong naka-fiber connection ka kung ang connection mo talaga is cable internet pala. Edi, what's the difference? Right?
Yeah.
'Di ba? So 'yun internet connection talaga. If that's something na improve na kahit na with that kahit na sinong siguro kahit sa sobrang desperado natin sa internet, kahit sino papatusin natin eh. Diba? Kahit yung bagong telco.
Yeah.
Diba?
Ano ba yun? Dito ba yun?
Hindi, doon.
Doon? Okay. Okay, Kuya Jay.
So, yun nga, no? Hindi, di pa naman nag-offer si Dito Telecommunity ng fixed line na broadband. Di pa nag-offer. More mobile talaga sila this time. And, I'm just not sure kung if things will go steady kasi with the very volatile environment that we have at the moment. Oo. Swerte lang ni Converge na naka-akyat-akyat sila. But I don't know with Dito, we have a different environment to enter. So, yun na, no? Okay. We talk about VTubers, we talk about internet connection, we talk about the current events. Ang bilis-bilis natin pahapyaw. I want to hear from you guys. Ano bang kwento nyo this time about VTubers? What's the moment that you look forward to in 2022? We start with Vivi.
2022, I'm looking forward to more Filipino VTubers kasi doon ako nakafocus usually. I've seen Cometa, I've seen Yashin Live, KLP, and I've worked with Daybreak, an upcoming group. If you haven't checked them out, they have their music video. I worked with the illustrations and soon their live 2D models will be drawn. I two members of the group will be drawn by me.
So yeah, I no, hope you guys
look forward. I have four children.
You have four children. Vivi Mama na pala, tawag ko sa'yo. Tawag namin sa'yo.
Vivi Mama.
So, yeah. That's already announced na kasi parang hindi pa nag-announce si Daybreak.
Ah, they've already released a short version of their music video.
Oo.
The full and the debut, they haven't announced it yet.
Yun yung that's something we look forward to, Daybreak. Kasi ang basehan ko lang naman pag sikat ng VTuber, marami kang clips.
Oo.
Again. Oo naman. Oh, di ba? Again, given the time na hindi ako I'm not the one who has long attention spans. I have short attention span. So short.
And you're a busy boy. Ako.
Oh. Busy boy.
Busy boy.
Oh, sige.
Busy boy keepsakes.
Okay. let's go with Arb. Arb, what do you look forward to in VTubers in 2022?
Now, ako kasi so super focused ako sa mga corpo VTubers. So I actually support a lot of corpo VTubers like not only Hololive ni Jisanji, like Riot Music, Vividonia, actually corpo JP VTubers. So ngayon nga lang ako nakikipag-interact dito sa Filipino community in regards sa VTubers. Eh. Bagong-bago lang talaga ako pagdating dito.
Uh-oh.
But the things that I really look forward to in 2022 are first because upcoming na naman ang Niji Sanji Fest sa February.
Oh,
fantastic.
Yeah, it's very big event by Niji Sanji. A lot of all of the livers all around the world are gonna be coming together to make that event happen just like last year. Mm-hmm. And second, syempre, January naman Hololive Fest. Anniversary na naman ng Hololive, 'di ba? Mm-hmm. So a lot back to back dalawang magkasunod na buwan.
Wait.
Big events.
May Hololive Super Expo. This March.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the whole March, third Hololive Fest.
Ah, okay. I think that's March.
March nila Pinesto?
Oh.
I think it's the Hololive Fest itself is January, and then the expo is something that they're gonna be following up to.
Okay, I'm looking at the Hololive website niya yon. 2022 March 19 to March 20.
That's magkasabay.
Expo and the third fest. Ako Hari Mese.
Ginawa nilang ano? March.
Sabay. Sabay.
Wow. Kasi, pero ang mismo kasing ano ng Hololive, like anniversary nila, is January. So,
baka yun lang yun, baka sinusulit nila yung space nila sa Mako Hari Mese. Mako Hari Mese yun.
Tsaka ano din eh, meron din kasing ano, upcoming live, solo live yung mga ano nila, members. Like for example, si Aqua sa February.
Oh.
So that's one of the biggest live na solo sa Hololive kasi sa Toyosu na naman ata sila ano kukuha ng ano pwesto.
Face, Toyosu Pit. Unlike last time, 'di ba, yung Bloom nila was somewhere along Tokyo. Yung may bago silang pwesto doon na
nag-Dome City, Tokyo Dome City.
Oh, okay. Tapos ano pa ba?
So as far as earlier events goes, ayun yung mga naglo-look forward ako. So mm-hmm. I think those events are really gonna help really cement the VTuber experience for this year. Kasi dito natin talaga malalaman whether VTubers will stay, especially ngayon na nagtra-transition na tayo sa ano, we're starting to go back to normal, right?
Back to normal, pero alert level 3 ang NCR ngayon.
I mean, yeah, ganun nga. Pero kasi, alam mo naman, hindi tulad naman last year na ang daming taong, like, they dropped off their jobs, dropped off schools, so they really have all of the time to watch these VTubers. Pero ngayon kasi, like, ang dami na ulit nag-enroll, ang dami na ulit naghanap ng trabaho.
Mm-mm.
So, ito natin malalaman sa year na to kung talagang cemented na ba yung VTuber industry.
Mm-mm. As an industry, as a community ba?
As an industry, oo.
Mm-mm. Well, good insight. Thank you. Kurumeme, what do you look forward to in 2022?
Pwede na Oshi ko.
Pwede na Oshi mo? Sino Oshi mo?
Yun?
Sama Joe. Kakarili lang ni Chigo.
Oo, nga pala, no? Chigo-chan, no?
Jigo, nung Pasko,
hinihintay ko si Akane, si Hisoy, si Ngo, tsaka si Koharu.
Ang hinihintay so, ko, I'm looking forward to 3D ni Hisoy because by lore-wise, iba yung mga story nila eh. Like si Chigo-chan, very casual lang. Tapos si Akane, yun pala, onesan na pala. Tapos onesan. Si Hisoy, tapos Hisoy, may ano pala to, may sci-fi lore.
May sci-fi, yeah.
Diba?
Bigla nga nagulat eh nung ano, bago niyang costume reveal.
Diba,
what?
Diba? 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 Kala kong ano eh, I'm already thinking of things in mind. When you make me remind of Celejo, Hisoy, eto, undercover agent to somewhere. Diba? And that's a good thing.
Baka katulad niya ni ano, Yuri Riri.
Who is?
Ano, time traveler.
Mm-mm.
But usually kasi Yuri kapag Riri. They don't do that for no particular reason at all, di ba?
Oh.
Yeah. Pagdating sa Niji Sanji, mga ganyang costume, usually related yan. Iba naman yung kay Chaika. Talagang trip lang talaga yon. Pero kasi, yung mga recent na ano wave ng Niji Sanji, usually, yung mga bagong costume nila tied sa kung anong plano nila for the next quarter. Tulad mm-hmm. nung ano, yeah. Niji Sanji system, right? Yung pinakamalaking reveal na costume sa may ano, sa may Tokyo Scramble, right? Kay Mayuzumi Kai.
Yeah. Ah, yeah, oo. Oh, oh.
Diba? Napakaganda reveal para lang sa costume.
Oo, oh, oo. Oh. Yun nga, yun, malupit din yung si Kai eh. Which reminds me, I still remember that kasi people watch that all over. That scramble.
Yeah. Ano yun eh, like, kasi naging elaborate puzzle siya. Oh. Tapos, and then, nung, ano, ang tawag sa buong puzzle like Niji Sanji system. Mm-hmm. So, when everyone figure out that the puzzle leads to the coordinates, tapos nung day na yun, ayun pala, isang malaking costume reveal. That was very awesome. Sobrang elaborate. Connected sa lore, and then they get to do a big marketing move.
Yeah. Niji Sanji supremacy.
Yes, Niji Sanji supremacy.
Hololive, bro.
Ay, grabe naman to, eh.
Grabe. Makakuha ka na ng ano niyan, mga bashers.
Meron na nga.
Canceled na talaga to.
Meron na nga. So, hindi na ako natatakot.
Hindi natatakot.
Naman ako about dun, eh.
Oo. Okay, so, yun, ano. What I'm looking forward in 2022, well, I'm looking forward. We've already seen Kahiro debut on 3D. We've already seen ano pa ba? Well, Cometa's first few months is still threaded with the challenges. Kaya yun nga, katulad ng internet ng Pinas, kung bakit galit tayo sa internet ng Pinas. Yeah. And okay, what do I look forward in 2022? Siguro kung babalik na yung in-person events, I look forward to a time na puro mga VTuber guests na lang yung kukunin ng mga events organizers.
Remember the anong tawag dito sa Cosmania yung yeah, ano survey yung nila?
Fanfest.
Yung survey?
Oo.
'Di ba they did survey for people doon?
Oo.
Kami talagang tinik namin VTubers tapos nilagay namin doon sa may ano sa parang fill up form. Please invite VTubers on again.
which they did naman. We've had the late Lyrica and Kahiro and then Yashin Live and then you know so on so forth. So yun nga no, looking forward to more VTuber guests tapos VTuber meet and greets. Para diretso na yung super chat. Oh, here's a red. Red envelope. Lalapag ko lang dito ah. Harap-harapang akasupa. Tapos salaman is 2,500 pesos.
Tapos bigyan mo agad 12,000.
Pak-pak. Bastusan with money gun.
walang nakalagay na message. Bagsakan mo ng 12,000.
That's it. That's it. Tapos malis ka na. Chad moves.
Chad. Giga Chad.
Ano pa ba? What do I look forward to in 2022? Ito. Here's, we already see this now with what's happening with the Cometa. No? They're doing Twitter spaces. Like, most VTubers nowadays are doing Twitter spaces. So, in the future, we already have VTuber podcasts nowadays. Pero yung ano, Twitter Spaces, it can be converted into podcasts. And once may playback feature na for Twitter Spaces for some. So one day, aww, one day makakakita tayo ng VTuber na vlogger talaga. We'll go back full circle. How about that? Kasi we have Ike Eveland eh, ni Jisanji, he says he's a virtual novelist. Na, well then, I'm looking forward to his novels. Like, kakiruta kami na, he's a light novelist. Yan. Yeah. Diba? Kung VTuber like, ka na video editor, you go with Kentama. Kung VTuber ka na blogger, I'm looking forward to meet you kasi wala nang nagbablog. Halos. Vlogging is a thing of the past. It's now vlogging or TikTokerist ka na.
Well, because it's pandemic. La.
La. So, most VTubers naman na nakikita ko, mga TikTokers din yan eh.
Yeah, ang dami nagbubukas ng ano TikTok ngayon.
Yung entry TikToker.
Oh, imagine being a TikTokerist.
Yeah.
Diba? So, yun ano, yeah, I think that's ano, and about the circular economy, kasi, di ba, ang circular economy natin sa VTubers, you create something out of nothing, and then you sell it at a price, at a value. At tulad sa music videos, hindi ka naman gagawa basta-basta ng music video na walang value. It has value. So, tama yung analogy ni Vivi kanina eh. So, gagawa ng music video, ipopost yung music video, may super chats. Tapos yung super chats, ano, ikot-ikot, papanggawa ng another music video na cover, and then it will add more super chats. Tapos, you know, that circular economy will prove to everyone na, parang despite na sabihin natin naghihirap yung Pilipinas, passionista ka pa rin, there's this one aspect, one subset ng creative community na lalaki itong creative community na to, provided that there's a steady turnaround nung ano mga creative assets like yeah. Assets sa some do give away their stuff pero it still has value. Therefore, something I look forward into the future, not just in 2022, is yung mga animators natin hindi nila sila animators for animation companies kasi andiyan yung mga VTubers eh. Everybody has their lore now. Everybody can have their own. Anyone can be an anime guy or girl now. Everyone has lore. So what's next? Gagawa kayo ng anime series. You know what? If Lyrica didn't retire or graduate, she could have had her own short anime series. No cap. Pero things just went differently. And di ba yung kita nyo mga debut? Yung mga debut na yan, okay. How simple was Vox's debut versus yung debut ni Ike Eveland versus yung debut ni Millie Parfait? I still see yung ano. O baga kung ano yung, kung, siguro sa lahat ng mga debut sa Niji Sanji, yan ang babalikan ko. Yung kay Millie. Because that was animated.
Oh yeah, the one on our debut.
Yeah, diba? Oo, yung debut. The lore itself. Yung first part nun, diba? Animated yun. And then, diba yung intro niya? Diba? So yun yung ano. We are looking forward to more of those kinds in the future.
Mm-mm.
Ako naman, as for me, manunod ako ng VTubers. I will simp. I will do super chats. And nowadays, I will now help an organization to develop its own news team na focus on VTubers. So, yeah, that's 2022 for me. Looking forward
Let's
for
get
more.
That bread.
Let's get that bread. Let's get that bread together. LGBT. Let's go.
Let's get that.
Tama naman, di ba?
Talaga.
GTB.
Let's get that bread together. Ikso. Okay, to cap up this show, Kurumeme, saan ka namin makikita?
YouTube.
Okay, sige, show ko na lang YouTube dito. Arb.
Basically, you can see me everywhere. Pag may nakita kang pangalan Arbed, ako 'yun. I basically pop out everywhere and anywhere. And basically, if you like need any help on like production stuff like that, you can go ahead and reach out to me, and I'm more than happy to help you arrange on anything that you need. Because like I said, or like was previously brought up in this podcast, na circular economy to eh. So as long as you're willing to give, those creators are also gonna be producing quality content for you, so that, you know, we can work together to make this, to make something really good.
All right, okay. So next up, of course, Vivi, where do we find you?
Me? You can find me on Twitter. I'm mostly active on Twitter at Vivirasuto. Vivi and then Rasuto, as in Irasuto, which is Japanese for illustration. And I am going to be opening commissions for VTuber illustrations this 2022.
Yay!
So look forward to that. And I also stream on YouTube and Twitch under the same username, Vivirasuto. So you can watch me there if you have free time.
Scout on the guy. Scout.
Scout.
Scout on the guy.
Scout. Scout.
Scout. Scout on the guy.
Scout on
what
the guy.
What is happening? I don't scout.
Discount.
Yay!
Discount.
Discount.
Yay!
Akala ko scout, as in boy scout. Yes, parang,
discount.
Discount on the guy.
Discount on the guy. Namumulubin na kami.
Gawin ko kayong babae.
Nako.
Kayong, ano, Joshi Kosei, payag kayo.
Okay lang para kung magiging tama
siya ko.
Payag kami, basta nga, discounted.
Oo.
Oh. Sige. At a small price of 300 USD.
Aray ko naman, pinapatay mo yung ano, tagiliran namin.
Isang avatar lang tayo, Arvin.
Tati.
Grabe.
Grabe. Okay, so as always, more podcasts coming this 2022. So, yeah, aside from Keepsakes the Podcast, podcast na siya ngayon kasi I'm more focused nga on with Anime Corner, as I'm saying. Stay tuned to Anime Corner as we will be opening applications for writers who would like to have an interest, who are interested in writing about VTubers. Alright, so yeah, aside from Anime Corner, an amazing show as well with Ike Divina, in which we are mostly talking about VTubers nowadays as well, but this time more on VTuber interviews. Ito kasi parang general VTuber talk na yung ginagawa natin, ano, and then some. So yeah, looking forward to 2022, that I find my happiness and you too find yours. This has been Keepsakes the Podcast, and I'll be meeting you and look forward to me and my future guests in the upcoming episode. Salamat, and again, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! Thank you for having us!
Happy New Year! Happy New Year, everyone!